Hello everyone, welcome to the new tutorial of AI Python. In this tutorial we are going to discuss about Notepad++ configuration. So in the last videos we have seen how to install Notepad++. Notepad++ is an easy to use open source editor. For they are used for many programming languages, Python, C, Perl, countless applications. Like there are a lot of languages which Notepad++ support. In this tutorial we are going to understand how we can use Notepad++ to edit our code. So this is basically a simple editor which can be used to write any code, and then you can run the code. So the basic intention of this tutorial is to make you understand how you can put some styling to your Notepad++ editor so that the code looks impressive. The color coding and all those. Live as if you were to die tomorrow. Learn as if you were to live forever. With this code, I'll start the video. So when we open Notepad++ editor, my Notepad is already configured, so don't worry about if your Notepad doesn't look like this. We'll show you how to make how to configure your Notepad++ to look in this fashion. So this is a normal window of a editor, a Notepad++ editor, and don't worry about the program. This is just a simple program I was writing. So this was for one of the GUI development, and this is for training and TensorFlow, and this is also one of the deep learning models that I was preparing. You don't have to worry about the code because this is a beginning session. I don't want anybody to get confused. The intention of this code is just to make sure that you understand the important changes, highlight important syntax like import, the keywords and all those loops and all. So we'll be covering in details. This video is not at all related to the coding. This is just to configure your Notepad++ editor to give you awesome feel, wow factor and all. So we'll start with the settings. Before I start with the settings, I'll try to discuss about the 2 points which is very important in this Notepad++ editor. The first one is the function. So this function list will give you the list of all the functions that are being used by this program. For example, if I click on this list, I'll see there's only one function. That it's not a function, basically it's a code. So I don't have any function defined in this code. But if I go to other here, I can see there are a lot of functions. So you can see the function map also. So in this UI quality check class, there are these functions are defined. So it will also show the tree architecture, tree hierarchy of the functions, like which functions are directly under the UI and which functions are under some different block. Let's say if more than 1,000 line of code, it's very difficult to scroll down and to reach out to a specific function. In this case, advantage to scroll to go to a specific function. For example, I want to go to this function. I'll double click it. I can go to this function. So I don't have to worry about where this function lies. So this gives a convenience when you write long code. It gives you convenience to reach down to a specific function. Okay. Similarly to this function, we have another very important tool in this Notepad that is called document map. So this also helps you to scroll down. So we'll see document map. So what it does look like, see, you can scroll down through here also. So if you want to scroll through whole code, you can scroll from here. This gives an abstract small view of the code so that you can reach to a specific portion, and you can scroll down up and down to reach to a code. Scrolling in this window will be very difficult because it will be 2000, 4000 line of code. In the beginning, it might not be convenient, but as and when you start going for a larger project, bigger project, these are the important tools that you will be needing. So this is I wanted to explain you in advance so that you can understand that how, why we are using this editor. There are many advantages why the many people are using this editor. So we can switch between document map and function list. So you can enable, disable. So generally I'll keep the function list enabled so that if I write a new function, it gets added to the list. So going forward, what we are going to do next is we are going to style this page, style this code. So how we can do that? We can go to the settings. There are two options, preference and style configurator. Style configurator deals only with the color and the program selection. For example, I am doing Python code, I'll select the Python and do the coloring scheme. So before style configurator, I would like to show you something on preferences. So when we go to preferences, we'll see a pop-up window which says like which language, what kind of icon you want to put, large, big, or standard, small, or you want to hide. This is for the toolbar. I mean to say this one. When you go to the second option, editing, you can see the folder margin options, like these are the folder margins options. So generally most of the things are as it is. You don't have to do any changes in this one. And then when we go to languages, this is important part. When you go to language, it says there are multiple language support. You can see a lot of languages are supported with by IDE, this Notepad++ IDE. And we are specifically focusing on Python. So in this language menu, if you want to disable, let's say I'm not coding in C hash. If you want to disable it, you can disable the item. So that means if you write C hash code, it not be recognized by this editor. I don't know why they have put to disable the item. Maybe it's for the convenience that if you have 2-3 codes in different languages, you should not confused, and then you can disable or enable at any time. If I want to enable it back, I can enable it. So this is one option for language. In the highlighting, this is very important feature of Notepad++ that I have seen. So this gives you highlighting. So suppose you wanted to select a specific word or text, like for example PyQt5. I want to see how many instances of PyQt5 are there in this whole program. So if I have, so when I enable it, we'll check with the disable. When we disable it, if we double click on it, only this is highlighted, only this one is highlighted. But if I enable it and again double click, it will see, it will check all the PyQt5 defined here. So see this one, or for example if I say to maybe like object name, so it will show you where are these same similar text file, or not file exactly, the text string or label or whatever, all the texts are highlighted. So it's easy to understand. For example, I have created this reference name. I wanted to check where I'm using this reference name in my code. So I'll double click it. It will give all the highlightings and I can check, okay, I have used reference here. So it was defined in the end, but okay. Once you double click it, it will highlight all the similar string in the code. So this is a very important feature, and highlight matching tags. These tags will be highlighted. So the next feature will go on to, I have never done this. I have never used this print function. I don't know. Maybe to print out the code and all, because I have never used this function. And then we'll go to auto completion. Auto completion is one of the features when you write, for example, display image. If you're writing display image and the second time again you want to write the same thing, if you write this, see, display image is available. So it gives an easy and convenient way to write the same text which you have already written. It gives you a hint of all the things which is started with this. So if I write with D, there, so not with the D, but okay. If I with D, I, and A, it'll come dialog, and D, I, S, P, it'll come DSP image. So you can easily save your time and write. You can directly select and write. You double click, it will be written. So these are the advantages which I have seen after using this Notepad editor almost from last 3 or 4 years. I have seen the big advantages, it's edge over other editors. And then when we go to search engine, we can see what kind of search we want to perform. Like for example, if I want to search something through Google, I can set it to Google, or you can custom, you can choose from the custom options. Like, so this was all about the preferences. Mostly it'll remain same. There's no much changes required. The changes are there in setting. In the settings, when you go to style configurator, we get this option. So what from here we can do, we can customize the themes completely. First of all, we have to select the language, like for which language we want to customize, because this is specific. If you select Python and you wanted the same code to be highlighted in MATLAB or some other root Ruby or Lisp, then it will not happen. So you have to select the language Python. From this option, once you selected language, you have default configurations available, like selected theme. So you can choose among these themes. So when you choose a specific theme, for each theme, a specific set of colors are assigned for different objects. For example, for text file, for text, for a string, for numeric value, for function, for keyword, there are different colors are assigned with this presets. What we can do in order to customize further, we can select a specific theme and then go to default. In default, it will show you which kind of foreground you want, which kind of background you want. So you can select out of this. Comment line, you can select what is the color of the comment line and what are the font of the color line, what is the size and all. So for the comment line, you can select this background color. For example, if I select this comment line to be grayed out and background color black, and we can see any comment. Let's see if we have commented anything. See, this one is the comment. So this is how you are making, when you will change this color, foreground color and the background color, this will change. So as of now, we have selected comment line to be in this color format and this text font style and the size. Similarly with the numbers, for the numbers, I have defined this color, so you can check the number. So this is number, and for these numbers are defined in these colors. So similarly, for every individual things, you can define your own style, whatever is most suitable and attractive to you. The strings also we have defined white. So for example, this this text is in white color because of these settings. I think you are getting it right. For character also, the setting is foreground. So character, generally string and character are similar. And for keywords, we have blue color. For example, let's say true, it's a keyword. So for true and all other keywords, let me say like def, class, these keywords are defined. So these colors will be defined for these keywords. Triples, for triple and triple double, these are the quotes that we use for defining text file, like 5 lines of code we want to do, and we want it to be just a readable format. Instead of putting a hash in front of every comment line, we can do a double and triple quote. This line of code will not be executed. Whichever are under triple quote are not executed. Okay, so and next one is class name. For class name, I want red color. So similarly, you see the class name is automatically, when you write class, it's in keywords, it will be in blue color, and when you write class name, it will be in red color. Similarly, def name in this color, operators, for example, plus, minus and all. So let's see if we have any operators. See, this one is the operator plus. So these are defined in yellow color. Similarly, identifier, common block and single end of line and all this. So with this, with the help of this style configurator, you can customize your code. This has nothing to do with the coding. It will not impact your coding at all. It is just a look and feel of the editor. So different people, based on their choice, based on their love towards a specific color they can define in their own way. I think this will help you to configure your config Notepad IDE. In case you have, if you have any problem, you want to ask some suggestion about your own style you want to configure, just let us know in the comment section. We'll definitely get back and we'll definitely help you out on this. I hope so. This is all for today's lecture. We are putting a lot of effort to make this video. I would really appreciate if you can share this video to the to anyone who wanted to learn Python from the basics. Then definitely it will be a great help from you guys. Please share this video, and if you like the content, then subscribe. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you so much for watching this video. We'll keep on adding the content, so please like, comment and subscribe. Thank you.